Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Ty, this is Dad, this is Reaction Extraction, and welcome. We're going to be doing Sam Fender. This is an artist, Dad's bringing me a newer artist.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Sam Fender, UK artist. This album, 17 Going Under, really seems to be taking off, and he's an interesting artist. Classified in like indie rock, indie pop, and I don't really know what that means today. Because before, pop music was in a separate realm. R&B and stuff was also, but then there was a difference between rock and then like alternative rock.
Yeah.
And Sam Fender here is alternative music. So is indie pop or indie rock like alternative from the past? Like what's alternative today?
Alternative? Well, I feel like alternative is kind of a hodgepodge.
Okay.
In general, but then you can have like alternative pop, alternative rock, alternative.
But is alternative rock indie rock? Indie pop?
From today's era, I would say no. But I feel like alternative, the word, the like the genre alternative kind of evolves throughout the decades. You know what I mean?
Okay, because in my day, 80s, 90s, alternative was Echo and the Bunnymen, The Cure. In the 90s, it would have been like a Radiohead. Mm-hmm. Okay, so alternative was more underground, hence, you know, hence the whole classification. It wasn't mainstream.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm losing the definition, or I have my definition, but it's more broad than I think I expect.
I think indie from today,
mm-hmm.
as I listen to it and you know, as I've been exploring, is more simplistic. It's kind of a more raw sound, kind of like made in your bedroom type feel.
So it's more stripped back.
Yeah.
So is it singer-songwriter?
It could be, yeah.
Okay, I still need to get my definition figured out of indie, because I think this is indie pop, indie rock.
But let's go ahead and listen to it, and we'll see what this vibe is.
Let's take a listen to Sam Fender, Getting Started, and then I want to have continue this discussion after.
Okay.
All right. You can help tell me what you think, what this is.
Yeah.
I guess what I'm saying.
Mama.
right?
I feel like you definitely could put this in like the indie pop, indie rock.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, I would still call it alternative.
Really?
Alternative rock. But I feel like, I mean, nowadays genres are so meshed, you know, it's kind of like a spectrum more than a categories.
Okay.
More
a spectrum.
You know, because like, there's so like, there's a type of song out there for everything, you know?
So
blending genres in every single way, so.
Okay, I'm trying to figure it out as I go along. So this is alternative, but indie also? Or wait, is indie more stripped back singer-songwriter?
I mean, not necessarily. It's just like the overall vibe, I guess.
So it's more vibe than the actual music stuff, like more guitar?
Yeah.
Bands used to be more alternative.
I was trying to, like, it feels like a band. I mean, like, I was trying to, like, put a finger on it, you know, but I can't, that's why I say, I feel like it could go into both.
Man. I can't put my finger on it either.
But I can show you some good indie artists.
Okay.
See if you want to compare. So.
And then we can compare the indie part to more of an alternative artist like a Sam Fender.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Or you can compare the indie attributes of this. Right. See if you can put your tongue on it. I mean, I don't know.
I really am trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what I need you for.
So, yeah. All right, guys. Well, let us know what you think. That
it's
was a great
song.
It's
not a dumb question, is it?
No, I don't think so at all. I mean, it's very blended.
Very blended
between the two genres, but
it's hard for me to adjust.
Yeah,
or identify. I don't.
But yeah, but let us know what you guys think. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and leave a comment on what you guys want to hear next, because we always are interested in what you guys are thinking. But yeah, we'll catch you on the next episode.
Thank you. We really appreciate it. Bye.